Good evening.
My name is Kirby Baxter, principal at Grandview High School. At this time, I would ask you to please turn off all cellular devices. I would also ask you to refrain from using noisemakers, loud talking, and shouting during the ceremony so that others can hear the graduates' names and accomplishments during the ceremony. If you will please rise as the graduates enter.
Thank you.
may be seated. I would like to welcome you to the commencement ceremony for senior class of 2021. I would especially like to welcome all the parents, grandparents, and relatives of these young men and women as they celebrate this important milestone in their lives. We'd also like to thank our friends at Cleveland IFC for allowing us to use this beautiful facility this evening. At this time, I would like to recognize the school board members of Grandview IFC, without whose leadership and support this event would not be possible. Beverly Barnes, Dr. Clint Calvert, Dr. Brad Collins, Clint Ishmael, Kai Martin, Keith Miller, and Derek Moore. We thank you for your support. At this time, Ainsley Tyler will give the invocation. Thank you, Ainsley. At this time, I'm asking you please rise to the playing of our national anthem.
Our class started with Carla Aguilar.
this time, so young, don't give her a kiss.
that I felt as if valedictorian speeches were supposed to spread some great wisdom, and I had nothing. I could not bring myself to stand before you, the Grandview graduating class of 2021, and speak about some pretentious lesson that I more or less followed during high school. But looking back, I did learn one thing. Life is brighter and easier when I do things in a way that work for me. That may sound odd from an outside perspective. Why had I not done things my own way before? The answer is both simple and complicated. As I stand here before you, I've been given the chance to speak because I won a competition. I was able to earn the highest GPA in our class, and it was this competition that drove me to adopt a comparison mindset. This comparison mindset drove me to look at how my peers do things, from practicing their instruments to taking notes of their calculus. I had a fear that if I did not do things the way that everyone else did, I would be unsuccessful. So I forced myself to behave just like everyone else, to the point of my own detriment. I used to spend outrageous amounts of time trying to perfect the methods of other people, and I was constantly trying to emulate those around me. I had decided in my head that there was only one way to success, and had never considered that trusting myself would ever work. However, something switched inside of me during our extended program. I no longer had anyone to compare to. Thus, I began to not worry about how other people did things and experimented with different methods. For example, I had always believed that the correct way to score and study was to work in long sessions and sit quietly at a desk while listening to music. And I only thought this because it was what I had deserved. However, throughout this last year, I discovered I get much better results in 25-minute sessions where I sit in silence, except for occasionally talking to myself to understand concepts, memorize information, and sometimes topics. Through my study habits alone, I learned a crucial lesson. There is no right way to live. There is no one-size-fits-all, and there is definitely no perfect plan for success. So I ask you, as you move out of this graduation ceremony into the next phase of your life, to experiment. Find what works best for you in every aspect of your life. And do not be intimidated by those around you who think differently. Believe in the method you have found to work and run with it. Seek out criticism and advice, but do not find yourself bound by those things that are not working. Your time here is short, and it is not worth spending trying to fit into someone else's world. Be yourself confidently and boldly every single day, because you are worthy. As I speak to you today, I am only confident that I do not know any advice that would fit every person here tonight, except that it is important to take your own path. Evaluate your methods often, check for success, and ebb and flow when things are not working. With all the success that the class of 2021 has added over the last 4 years, believe in your ability to overcome challenges in your own unique way. Class of 2021, you are extremely intelligent and much more capable than you know. And I'm honored to have been your valedictorian. For now, I wish you happiness and good fortune in the future. I can't wait to see our impact on the world. It has been a great honor.
Members of the Grandview High School School Board, I present to you the class of 2021 as candidates for graduation. They have fulfilled all of the academic requirements set forth by the Texas Education Agency and the Grandview Independent School District, and are therefore eligible for graduation. Will the first row please rise? Thank you. Macy Lee Barker. Brianna Lynette Freshwater.
Ariel Catherine Hancock.
Emily Brianna Hernandez. Ryan Lane Hurd. Colton Jacob Bowman.
Nicole Brady.
Cooper Reed Quistberry.
Hunter James Watson.
Caleb Allen Westside. Carla Joanna Sorelli.
At this time, if you will please rise for the recession.